Hello students, in previous class we understood the physical quantity electric field and how to define and measure its magnitude. In today's class we will understand electric field as a vector quantity and how to find its direction. Electric field or electric intensity represented by E vector is a vector quantity, means which has both magnitude and direction. Always E is measured at a point, that is a specific or particular point in the electric field. The point concept in this one is very important. We cannot say simply around a space. It is always measured at a specific particular point. Keep this in mind. Whenever we call it as find the electric field, the student must think which is that point we have to find the electric field. Next, if it has a magnitude and direction, at a single point we have to find both magnitude and direction. E has its magnitude and specific direction at a given point. And yesterday we discussed magnitude of electric field or electric intensity. It is an electric force F experienced by unit test charge due to source charge at that point. If we keep a charge Q at the point P, we have to find the electric intensity magnitude. Then we have to keep a test charge of any magnitude Q naught. Then electric force experienced by unit test charge. This is not unit test charge, it is any magnitude of charge. Then the coulombic force experienced by the given test charge is going to be Q naught due to this charge. This is what we call it as F. Then this is the force experienced by given quantity of test charge, but the magnitude of electric intensity is electric force experienced by unit test charge. The unit test charge means F by the given test charge. If I divide, it becomes unit test charge. The force experienced by Q naught per unit test charge. This itself is the magnitude of electric intensity at a given point. This is what we understood yesterday, and it is measured by the SI unit Newton per Coulomb, or another equivalent, this unit SI unit volt per meter. Now we'll discuss the electric intensity direction. Electric intensity direction identifying is one of the important thing in our classes, because the whole subject depends upon the identifying the electric field. The direction of E at a given point is, always we use the word electric intensity at a given point, not at any point. Always we are going to identify given point. In the direction of electric force, the direction of electric intensity at a given point is, it is in the direction of electric force or a coulombic force acting on plus 1 coulomb of charge due to source charge at that point. See, these things, there is no need to bahat or understand anything. It is a two-step activity, very simple way we can understand. That is, in the two-step activity to find the direction of electric intensity, First, identify the point where to find the electric intensity direction and consider plus 1 coulomb at that point. This is the first step you have to do. Find out where, which is the point you have to find out, and consider that there is a plus 1 coulomb of charge. It is a mental activity. It's the first step. Then find the electric or coulombic force direction acting on plus 1 coulomb due to source charge. If you done these steps 1 and 2, that is the direction of electric field, then the direction of coulombic force or electric force itself is the direction of electric intensity at that point. And the most important thing is always denote electric intensity direction with proper arbitrary notations to identify correct and respective source charge. Always the student think that electric intensity is the only one single case we are going to identify. That is not the only important thing. We had to give the proper notations to solve and understand the complete concept of the given problem or theory, because as we move into the higher concept like dipole moment and potential and every time potential and other related concept, we need the direction of electric intensity. Therefore, we must very clearly understand the direction of electric intensity to understand the other concept. That's why we had to mention the proper arbitrary notation to identify correct respective source charge. It is left to the student's ability and their convention to give the arbitrary notation for them. We will discuss later how we are can give them. Exactly like electric coulombic force we have done. Whatever the theory we have understood here, we are going to realize this is important. Whatever here it is a theoretical part how to find, but in practically this is the thing everyone has to understand. Find the electric intensity at a point P in these two cases. Now, to find the electric intensity at the point P, first we have to identify the, see the two steps. The first step is to identify the point where to find the electric intensity. This is the point. Clear? And consider 1 coulomb at that point. We have to assume or we have to mentally have to keep this is 1 coulomb of charge. There is no need to keep this plus 1 C physically. Mentally have to feel or you have to consider it's a plus 1 coulomb of charge is present at the point P. Then this first step is over. Then find the electric or coulombic force F direction acting on plus 1 coulomb of charge. This 1 coulomb, whatever we consider here, what is the coulombic force acting on this due to source charge? The direction of force acting on this due to source charge is this. Now, how to find the coulombic force direction on this? We already learned this in the charges, the basic coulombic Coulomb's law. The direction of coulombic force is always acting along the line joining the two charges. Here the two charges is plus 1C and source charge. This is the acting along the line joining. It is not the final direction. First we have to assume the line is going to be there here, line joining this along the line. Now plus 1C direction, the force act experienced by plus 1C due to the source charge, this is a positive, always this is plus. This decides the direction of electric force. Now, this electric force is experienced by this, by plus Q is going to be this also positive and this is also positive. Then this experience the repulsive force which is pushing this way and is acting along the line joining the two charges along OP in this direction. This is the force experienced by charge at P due to charge at O. This is the notation what we have done in the Coulomb's law. Similarly, the most important thing is giving the electric intensity direction also. Now, force is this, then what's the direction of electric intensity? The electric intensity direction is the direction of F is the direction of E. This is the direction of E also. Means instead of F, you write your E, then both are same direction. E, then the notation. Always denote E direction with proper arbitrary notations. Arbitrary notations here, this electric intensity is acting at the point P. The similarly like electric force, you represent properly electric intensity at P due to the source charge O. Means E, the representation at the direction, where you represent the direction, there only you have to represent clearly P due to charge. This is what the direction of electric intensity. You will understand another example. Find the electric intensity at the point P due to the source charge minus Q, which is present at O. At the two step, first identify the point where to find the E at the point P, and consider one coulomb at that point. At this point you have to consider plus one coulomb, and find the coulombic force experienced, direct coulombic force direction experienced by the plus one C, which is kept at point P due to the source charge. The source charge nature is minus here. Due to this always act along the line joining. First this is a line joining between the both the charges. And now plus 1C experience what type of force? It is an attractive force, because a minus, this is going to be plus. This is a positive charge and this is a negative charge. But we have to check the what is the force experienced by plus 1C, not this. Then plus 1C, this is attractive and it is acting towards this. This is a F, force experienced by charge at P due to charge O. This is the direction. This is a coulombic force direction. This itself is the direction of electric intensity at this point. This is a E. This is also arbitrarily and well defined notation is electric intensity at P due to the source charge, which is present at O. That's it.